nice path.
I'm back here too.
I get it.
Don't want to swim for it this time of year.
No.
I may be warm, but I'm not that warm.
September 26th, 2021. My friend, Jim Dodd, and I set off from the Slim Lake entry point for another fall Boundary Waters trip. It was cloudy with a few sprinkles as we set out, but the temperatures were decent and the forecast called for improving conditions for the bulk of our trip. If anything, the gloomy skies helped to make the autumn colors stand out that much more vividly. The campsite I really wanted was towards the northern end of the lake, but there was no guarantee it would be open. So we decided to check the campsites at the south end first to see if they were available. With calm conditions, the paddling was easy and enjoyable. The extra time on the water would be no problem.
I don't really want the one down there. I know that. But it'd be nice to know if there's somebody already there.
Okay. Maybe we ought to nab this one while unless somebody, you know, might, well, nobody's coming in, right?
Right. As far as we know, nobody's coming in. It's just that the, you know, the one up there, if it's empty, the one towards the north, if it's empty, I know it's
a really good one.
A really good one. But at least we know there's one empty down here.
Yeah.
I guess we should maybe check it out real quick and see if it's worth coming back for. I guess it's empty, it's worth coming back for, right? Yeah, it's right down towards the end of the lake. You see that big cliff on the right side there?
Yeah.
It's pretty much right opposite that.
Well, this map shows it's on the other side.
Ah. Well, your map's wrong.
Okay.
The reason I know is that I've taken pictures of that cliff from the campsite,
yeah.
So.
Well, I'm just
yeah, I know.
That's
why it's good to have two maps along.
Or somebody that's been here before.
That helps too. Like I said, the campsite itself is great. It just doesn't have any views. I mean, you could fit a troop of Boy Scouts in there.
Oh, there's room. Okay.
There's room. You know, one of the things I look for in a campsite is a good view.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely.
Being able to look at the lake, sit out by the lake.
You know, coming from Iowa, this all looks great.
I understand. Even coming from Rochester, this all looks great. But I live in Ely sometimes now.
So you can be a little more...
I'm not so easily impressed. Oh, what a gorgeous day.
Yeah.
We picked it this time. And we picked the right time this time.
We found that the two southernmost campsites were available. And... if need be, they would be okay to use, but it would be so much better if we could get the one further up the lake.
That campsite is actually empty too?
It looks to me like it is.
Unbelievable. Where's everybody staying?
Yeah. Everybody was chomping at the bit to do that 500.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure. There must have been a fire here at one time. Yeah, I see a lot of black.
Mm-hmm. Well, this point here seems to have burned.
Yeah. Yep.
Ryan and I noticed that when we were here in the winter.
Okay.
But it's just to the point.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you don't know what.
There
was signs of another winter camp right back in this bay. Somebody had camped there.
There's somebody there.
Is there?
Yep.
Darn.
I can see movement in the trees. So, then this next one is one that's...
The next one is no good.
Okay.
We can always find out. I guess we could always find out if they're planning on leaving today.
Yeah, that's true, too.
You know, Jim and I are at the Primo campsite on Slim Lake here. This is the landing. And right behind me.
Two thumbs up.
Two thumbs up so far. Right behind me here is a great place to store the canoes. We go up the hill here. Follow Jim up the hill. This is the campsite. Nice place right here to set up a tent. Nice and big. You shouldn't have too much trouble setting up your tent here, should you?
No, this is perfect. Yep, there's a nice spot right there.
And,
I don't know where you're going to set up.
Well.
But my orange tent will really, there's a nice spot
yep.
back in here too.
There's a nice spot back in there.
Yep.
In fact, I think this might be where I had my tent before. I don't know. But here's the cooking area. Kitchen area. And look at the view. There's an island off the over there. Just off the campsite. And here's the vista of the lake. There is, let's see. Yeah, I think I'm going to have to put my tent up back in that screened area. There's the trail over here. Pretty sure leads to the latrine. Here's the latrine. It's a newer square one with a lid on it. Look at the fall colors in here. Isn't it gorgeous? Okay, I'm on my way back to the campsite now. Here. Wait, we hit it good for the maples. This year, man, the maples are just fantastic. Look at this. I think we're going to call this home, aren't we?
Absolutely. Yeah, well, this has got everything else. Wow, look at the view, and you got to look through the, you know, you can get a little edge view of the trees on the outline of it.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, this is awesome. Yeah. Five stars.
Five stars, yep.
There's at least two or three more pads in there.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And... yeah, there's one there. There's
right
one here. I don't know if we got any more, but go. And the campers would be happy.
Yep.
nice place for a tarp set up right in here if you mm-hmm. wherever you were thinking. Yep. Boy, to me this looks like mm-hmm. perfect right here.
I think when I was here before, I set up my tent basically tarp. Where you're going to.
Okay.
And I think I have my tarp back in
back
where
there.
I'm going to have my tent.
Yep,
I think, if I remember right, you know, they all blur together after a while. But
there's some really, there's a great big old white pine over there that's mm-hmm. huge round. And here's one here too. That's...
Yeah, this is just a fantastic sight.
Yes.
So I'm glad. Glad we were able to get it.
Yeah, well, that was, you know, I... And as we were coming, you know, she was kind of, I could tell she was doing dishes, you know, and
uh-huh.
like, well, you know,
yeah,
and he was standing back in here a little ways. So I can see where they might not have seen us, but
yeah, but I, you know, I couldn't see a tent up or a hammock or anything.
No. So I thought, well,
yeah, it looks like they might be packing up to go.
Yeah.
Sure enough. Yep. See, yep. Sometimes it doesn't hurt.
Observations.
Doesn't hurt to ask sometimes.
Absolutely.
It's like my last trip when I had the, when I asked those women if they were staying on that site or when they were having their lunch.
This might be a challenge here for a stake.
There we go. This place put up.
Let me put a rock on this. I like these triangular stakes.
Oh, really. Yeah.
They're durable and they invisible. They only cost a buck. I guess I got one here that's bent.
Yeah, I bet you're happy you didn't have to do any more portaging.
Yes, I am. Yep. I don't see any reason to move in this spot from this spot. Do you, Larry?
Nope. I will want to take a day trip over towards Rice and Hook. But if you want to stay here fishing, that's fine. Or if you want to come with me, that's fine too.
Yeah, that sounds like a fun thing. Yeah, if I'll yeah, I'm all for a day trip over.
Okay.
Wow.
Okay, standard Thermarest, had it for a number of years now. My Eureka Mountain Pass 2 XTE, the tent. And once again, I have my Kelty Cosmic down, dry down, 40. It's actually supposed to be pretty warm this trip. Lowest low I saw was 40. But a lot of nights it's only supposed to get down in the 50s. And towards the end of the week it's actually supposed to get up into the upper 70s. So it's almost like being in camping in the summer. Well, hello there. Larry Ricker, aka Nibby Mox, here. I'm on Slim Lake in the beautiful Boundary Waters. Today is September 26th. Is that right? Yeah. September 26th, 2021. I'm in here with my good friend Jim Dodd. We've got about a four or five day trip. And it's starting out gorgeous. I mean, absolutely fantastic. We had calm water, almost glass coming in, and blue skies. It was cloudy to start with. In fact, we got sprinkled on a little bit to start with. But the sky gradually cleared. Now it's blue, hardly a cloud in the sky. And the colors are just starting to really get intense, especially the maples. So there's a lot of reds and oranges, and just beautiful out here. Although, you know, still a lot of green because the poplars and the birches haven't started changing yet. Temperature is perfect. It was about 70 degrees today. Tonight's going to be the coldest night, and it's only getting down to 40 tonight. It's supposed to be upper 40s tomorrow night, and it's supposed to be in the 70s and slowly climbing over the days that we're here, so that the lowest was today the lowest high, and it's supposed to be in the upper 70s for a couple of days towards the end of the week. So we picked an excellent time to come in here. No rain in the forecast until Thursday night, and we're either going to go out Thursday or very early on Friday. What we did today, let me show you what we did. So again, we're on Slim Lake. So we came in this morning here's the entry point for Slim Lake. There were four cars in the parking lot, and there's not a lot of campsites in this loop, so that got us a little bit concerned off the bat of what the campsite availability was going to be. But we came on into the lake, and we decided to head down this way to start with, and we checked out this campsite here, which of course I have been to before, haven't stayed on it. It's a nice campsite in that it's got lots of room for tents and everything, but it doesn't have a very good view of the lake from the campsite itself. But anyway, that was unoccupied, so Jim went in and checked it out, and he agreed with me that it was an okay site and would be okay to stay on if we really needed to. Now there's another site that doesn't show up on here that's about in here, and we checked that one out. That was a fairly decent site as well. Unfortunately, there were a lot of rocks and roots, so even though it was pretty wide open, a lot of pine trees and everything, we did find places that we could set up tents if we wanted to, but it wasn't the best. So we decided that what we would do is come up, and of course I knew that this site here was a primo site on the lake. So we decided to come up and see if this was empty, knowing that if it was taken, we could paddle back down here. Again, conditions were perfect this morning, so paddling back down would be no problem, and we would probably take this site here. As it turned out, there was a couple on this site, but it looked like they were packing up to go home. So we got their attention and asked if that's what they were doing. Found out that yes, indeed, they were packing up to leave. So we just hung out, did a little bit of exploring out here, paddling around out here, I did notice that there was a party up on this site up here, which isn't a very good site, and I wouldn't have wanted to go up there anyway. So we waited until that couple left, and then we landed, and we set up camp, and we've been basically chilling ever since then. Jim spent a lot of time in the tent. I did some futzing around, did some battery charging and stuff like that. Then I went into the tent for a little while too. I'm taking advantage of the fact that Jim's out looking for wood right now to get some videoing done. And like I said, so we're going to base camp here. We'll probably take a day trip over to at least Rice Lake and possibly Hook Lake. Probably tomorrow, because the wind's kind of, at least the forecast calls for slightly increasing winds over the next few days. So probably take a day trip tomorrow. Jim's going to do some fishing. We'll do some exploring. Might try, like I did a few years ago when I was here in the spring, might go and climb up that bluff over there. Yeah, I'm sure there's going to be some nice views from over there. So probably do that kind of thing. But basically this is going to be, as a trip with Jim usually is, going to be kind of a laid back, easygoing trip. So I'm hoping I find enough to keep the videos interesting, but not real sure I'll be able to do that. But this trip is about relaxation, not about pounding out the miles or spending a lot of time paddling. Most likely I'm going to be able to go out for an evening paddle tonight. I don't see why I wouldn't be able to. It's, like I said, it's absolutely gorgeous. So that's kind of the intro to this trip. And I'll talk to you later. It's almost supper time.
Hit your camera.
Yeah, don't hit my camera.
No matter how much battery you have, right?
Right.
Is
that the one camera?
Not very good wood, but
nice and dry. Of course, that's not surprising this year.
Shop back to clean it up. Oh, I knew I forgot something. little 20 volt lithium ion shop back.
Yep.
Something's been biting on my arm, but I don't know.
Huh.
Will they have no seams this time of year, or is it just a...
Not usually, but of course this year, who knows? 1 2/3 cups. As well, leave that pot on there. That'll meet dishwater water later on. So my supper tonight, if you haven't guessed already, beef stroganoff with noodles. Mountain House. First night of a trip, of course, that's what I'm gonna have. Ready for the big unveil now. Is it stroganoff?
Well, I can smell it. It smells good.
Yeah, it smells good. It looks good. Yes.
Yes. Is the camera going now?
Yep, the camera's going now.
Sorry.
It's okay. No problem. You didn't say anything wrong. You didn't swear. You didn't.
No, I usually don't unless I get really upset. But, and it doesn't help then either.
I got just the right amount of water again. Look at that.
Just looks right. Yep.
Yes. Definitely a thumbs up. Thank you. Well, it's about 9 o'clock, a little bit after nine, and we're heading to bed now. So it's been a really, really nice day. A few sprinkles this morning, but boy, the lake was calm. Nice colors today. Beautiful. It turned out pretty sunny and warm. Getting a little bit chilly now, but this is supposed to be the coldest night of our trip. So yeah, had a wonderful time. Got a really nice campsite, of course. Beautiful lake. Got out for an evening paddle, which was nice. Got really lucky with the campsite that we got. So yeah, it's been a all around a fantastic day. So heading to bed now, and Jim gathered some firewood earlier on today, but we decided not to have a fire after all. It was just fun watching the lake and the stars appear, and yeah, but it's getting, like I said, it's getting a little bit chilly now, so decided to turn in. And looking forward to another nice day tomorrow. So thanks for coming along today, and hope to see you on trail sometime. Nibby Mox out.